Government through the years has kept on promising a better life for the police officers and rejuvenation of all barracks where most officers and their families stay. Unfortunately, the police officers' wives say that most of these promises have been dragged on without being fulfilled. Today, the Secretary General of the National Resistance Movement Party, Richard Todwong, engaged the aggrieved spouses of the police officers. The meeting was held at the NRM Secretariat at Chadondo in Kampala. During this meeting, the police officers' wives expressed their disappointments over the poor living conditions in the barracks. Some of them pointed out low salary pay to their husbands, despite the tough economy which comes with a lot of demands.
Our husbands, they are getting, is he aware that a police who is getting 400,000, out of that 400,000, they get a loan of five million for 5 years. Someone is having 10 kids, 5 kids. To pay that loan, you might find a person now is earning 200,000, 150,000. To pay for the kids and to pay for all accommodation, we are suffering.
I know His Excellency is aware of it. Go and talk to him. Say that women are not happy.
They asked for permission to set up worship centers in the barracks to give hope to the frustrated police officers, alleging that some have started committing suicide because of losing hope.
Whenever the barracks, they should put a church. There is a reason why I'm saying like that. I'm seeing there is a lot of suicide in the police officers, including even us women.
Accommodation is very poor. Because you get a police officer occupying one room with 5 children and some are grown up. Please, sir, we seek your help.
The police officers' wives also raised the point of the delay to get benefits for their husbands once they pass away.
Orphans in the barracks, those are the children above 18 years. Remember that child before the father or mother dies? This child had already left the school. He's moving alone like that. He has no help, no what, but waiting for this benefit. When that time comes, these children and these widows, they are thrown out of the barracks.
Is it ever my husband is being deployed night for 7 months? Is it in order, sir? But because they know I'm the person squeezing them in NRM in the barracks.
However, some police officers' wives testified that they have benefited a lot from government development programs such as MYOGA, NADS, Parish Development Model, and Skilling. They have asked government to fund their circle groups so that they can be able to live a better life.
For that, the government has made us to benefit in some areas. We have NADS program, where the families of police have benefited. We have CBO, community-based organization, where people are organized in groups and they benefit from entandikwa of 5 million shillings.
The NRM Secretary General, Richard Todwong, made the commitment to follow up and work with relevant authorities on all the issues presented to him, adding that the party decided to interact with the officers' wives to find a way forward and also support their endeavors and activities in the barracks for the welfare of their families.
Of administrative nature, issues of working environment of your spouses, working gears and all that, we shall discuss with the police authority. Then we shall see how it can be improved. On the issue of having churches in the barracks, that is beyond our mandate. We know you have to relate with your spirit, but we have taken note of what Mama said, that there are a lot of suicide cases in the barracks, which is out of, I think, stress and some other things, which should be attended to. That we have taken note. We shall also discuss with the police authority.
Todwong commended them for supporting the NRM party and their spouses when on duty. Report compiled by Jali Adnamwaya for the news.